It's a great day at MS Classic Cars. I'm Mark Shalero, the owner, and I'm sitting behind the wheel of a spectacular 1960 Chevrolet Biscayne Custom that has a Lingenfelter supercharged LT4 V8 pushing 750 horsepower, and this car is also sitting on an Art Morrison chassis. I have nicknamed this vehicle Great White. Come take a ride. To start off this video here, this is non-rehearsed. There's a lot of information about this vehicle that I'm going to forget. I did bring my binder here to reference some of the notes, so I will try to touch base on as many things as I possibly can, but please visit our website at msclassiccars.com for a full description with tons of highly detailed photos. We really, really do the best presentations we can so you know exactly what you're looking at and we can be as transparent as possible. If you have or have not been following MS Classic Cars, I only collect number one and number two condition vehicles. We own all the vehicles that we sell. We're very proud to say we're the only classic car dealership in the country who services every vehicle we sell. We document that work with an invoice, which we post in the photo gallery. So in this new binder that comes with every car we sell, I've included this invoice. We invested a total of $4,007.91 in this particular car. Spend the time, check it out, review what we've done to it. Be rest assured, this vehicle is ready for its new owner to enjoy. Once the vehicles are done in the service department, we take great pride in detailing our vehicles. We literally can spend days upon days with each car individually, starting with the undercarriage, the engine compartments, interiors, exteriors, and so forth, which is clearly evident in our photo gallery. So, touching base on the story of this car, the first thing I want to do is I want to give a shout out to the people who are responsible for restoring this car. So there's no confusion at MS Classic Cars. We do not do restorations. What we do is we buy vehicles, we service them, we cosmetically improve them. There's a few things that we've done to this vehicle that I'll go over during this presentation, but the true accolades need to be given to the people who do the restorations. So I'd like to say both the names Ben Smith and Dave Crego of McConnell Motorsports. They are the ones who restored this vehicle. They did a fantastic job. I would say this is probably the best equipped custom car that we've ever had at MS Classic Cars. I think when you learn more about this vehicle, you will definitely agree. So I first nicknamed this car Great White because of its shark like fins that are all around the vehicle, its size, and of course its mean demeanor. This car is a true street thumper. It is absolutely bad to the bone. So the vision that they had at McConnell Motorsports was to make a radical street machine that had all of the comfort and conveniences of a new vehicle today, but they wanted to keep the classic look and appearance of this seldom seen Biscayne body style. Touching base on that for a minute, you do see a lot of popular classic cars all the time. We have them here, Mustangs and Camaros and Bel Airs and Chevelles and Novas and Corvettes and things like that. But very rarely do you see a Biscayne. This is an unbelievably cool car. They were super well designed. They just really speak volumes just when you look at these cars. So again, super proud of this vehicle. It's extremely rare. The story goes, this vehicle, as the VIN number indicates, was built in Tarrytown, New York, as a 60 Biscayne two-door sedan with a six-cylinder engine. When they found the vehicle, it was a very original vehicle. A lot of the times, these vehicles need a ton of sheet metal replacement. This particular vehicle did not need any sheet metal replacement except the rear bottom sections of the rear quarter. So they had to do a little bit of work in there, no big deal whatsoever. They spent countless hours upon hours making this car better than the factory ever did. The body work is phenomenal. All of the gap lines are awesome. The hood opens beautifully. The doors open beautifully. The trunk lid opens beautifully. You look down this car, it's laser straight. Again, I have to give credit for the great job that they did with the body on this vehicle. Getting into the paint is high show quality paint. Because this car was finished in 2019 and it has less than 200 miles on the restoration, it's about as flawless as you'll find a vehicle. Again, because it was just finished and it clearly shows with how bright everything is and how new everything is. This was a full-blown rotisserie restoration. It was truly a labor of love. So the paint on this vehicle is actually a GM white paint. They refer to it as white base. It's kind of a little bit of a creamy white. You can see the difference between our floors and the color of this car. There's slightly a different shade there. They could not have picked a better color, in my opinion. It fits the car like a glove. So again, the quality of the paint is absolutely stunning. When we get into all of the glass came from a company, which I'd like to just reference this quickly here. It came from a company called Auto City Classic Glass. All the glass was replaced brand new, every single piece of the glass. Windshield, these vents, the windows, the quarter windows, and the rear windshield, the glass looks spectacular, and all of the glass is tinted. When I was talking with Ben on the phone about the restoration, I had asked him about all of the bright work. I said, this bright work is truly stunning. Talking about the grill, talking about the bezels, the bumpers, the mirrors, all these types of things. He said, Mark, everything that was on the car is original. We sent it out. We had it all professionally restored. That's why it fits like a glove. Again, you're talking about thousands of dollars that were invested, not just in the body, the paint, but also all the bright work on the car. It looks truly spectacular. Some of the things that were done to the exterior, again, they wanted to keep the classic look, so there's not a ton of things that were modified on the exterior. He had mentioned to me, and again, I'm just referencing these notes here to make sure I accurately describe it, but he had told me that there was these little caps that were on the rear quarters by the taillights that came with these cars from the factory. He smoothed those out for a little bit of a cleaner look. And some of the other things that were done, it does have modern headlights in the vehicle. And of course it has LT4 Supercharged emblems, which just give it that perfect look. Again, it does have these dual chrome mirrors and so forth. The vehicle sits on Billet Specialties Stiletto wheels that are 18 inch in the front, they're 20 inch in the back, and the wheels are wrapped with Pirelli P Zero tires. Again, no expense was spared on that. It has an unbelievably beautiful stance. And again, he didn't want to go with a wheel that looked too modern because then it would throw off the look. So he wanted to go with something that looks somewhat era correct in the torque thrust style design. I think he nailed it. It looks absolutely awesome. Again, great white. this is definitely a shark for sure. And those sharks can be fast. And as I tell you more about this car, you're going to realize how fast it is in just a minute. So as we get talking more about this car, it really led to discovering what was done to this interior. When this car came off the trailer, and my team and I were doing our first visual inspection of it, besides the bodywork, the paint, the stance, and all that stuff, the glass, everything was perfect. We looked at this interior, we smelled it, it was unbelievable. Words cannot describe this interior. We have a 55 Bel Air that we're going to be selling at the Barrett Jackson auction, and that vehicle has a Ron Mangus interior. That was at the highest level that we've ever had at MS Classic Cars regarding interiors. I'm going to put this interior on the same level. So what I want to do is I want to give a shout out to John Miller, who is extremely helpful. He's from Hyde's Original. If you Google him and his company, he's the one who is fully responsible for doing this entire interior. Matter of fact, it was him who put me in touch with Ben, who did the restoration at McConnell Motorsports. So again, I really want to give John a shout out for doing such a beautiful job with this interior. So first, let's get into the headliner. The headliner is all black. It's extremely tight. Again, it reeks of leather. It's absolutely beautiful. The dome light was placed right in the center. It's in great working order. The sun visors match the headliner perfectly. The entire dash is all black. Again, it's in beautiful condition. All of these gauges here, these are Dakota Digital gauges. They look beautiful. They're all functioning. They're all in working order. It does have a tilt black steering column with these custom levers here and so forth. When we got the vehicle, it actually had a different steering wheel in it. We contacted Billet Specialties. It's a company that we deal with on a regular basis. We asked them to supply us with a Stiletto steering wheel that matches the Stiletto wheels. We thought that was a great addition to the interior. Came out awesome. So again, steering wheel is brand spanking new, literally out of a box. We just put it in here. Again, it has vintage air conditioning. It has custom made billet style vents that you will clearly see in all of our photos. It has a upgrade retro sound system, which is a sound system that is made to look old, but it's actually new. They placed custom speakers throughout the vehicle, including these little tweeters that are on this actual part of the dash here. I am going to go on record and say this whole front fascia, this whole interior is like brand new. Getting into the doors, these doors are very soft, high grade leather. They've got these chrome accents. They got these custom arm rest pieces here that have red stitching. They've got billet hardware, such as the door handles and so forth. The seats that I'm actually sitting on, these are brand new seats. They feel like I'm sitting in a brand new car. They've been completely redone, spring foam, etc. And they not only wrap these seats, which this is really cool, they not only wrapped them with black with the red stitching, but they also encompassed this houndstooth interior pattern here, which would have been found during the 60s in these cars. So they wanted to tie in some of that originality to the interior. So I thought that was a great idea, which obviously matches the white on the exterior. They could not have done a better job. It's obviously flowing into the back seat as well. They just did a super job. They even have these chrome appointments on the seats, both front and back. Can't really say enough about this. These seats, they move forward and backwards really, really nicely. There's front seat belts, there's rear seat belts. We get into another favorite part of the interior of mine, the center console. What a beautiful job they did with the center console. Again, you have to check this out in the photo gallery. Even the shift boot is leather. It's got the red stitching on it. It's got all the chrome accents. Of course, you have to put a white shift ball in here as well. And then right at your fingertips, below the shift knob, are all of your power window controls. Not only does it have power vents, but it also has power windows, both for the driver, passenger, and for the rear passengers as well. They also, and I'm referring to the rear passengers, also have their own power window switch in the back. The power windows in this thing work awesome. When you open up this console here, which opens and closes beautifully, you will notice a storage compartment that's in there as well. So again, this interior, even the carpeting is a classic style carpeting, high grade. It's got matching floor mats. Again, I cannot say enough about this interior. When we make our way to the trunk compartment is a spitting image of the interior. It was all boxed. They did a gorgeous job with that. A lot of the times it's a hassle to remove panels and things. What they did is they made it magnetic. So when you want to access the panels that are in the trunk, both on the left side and on the right side, you can actually just pull them down instantly. And one side actually has storage. The other side has the battery with a battery tender. This car is powered by an Optima battery, which is a great name in the battery world. It does have its own custom Optima aluminum battery case as well. So that is definitely a really cool deal. Again, I cannot say enough about the upholstery work in the interior and in the trunk compartment. So as we move on to the engine bay, this is where things get really fun. Of all the cars that we've owned, I'm trying to think anything that's older. I'm going to go back from, let's say, 1970 and older. This is hands down the fastest motor that we've ever had in a car at MS Classic Cars. So these engines are awesome engines. They come in different variations depending on wet sump or dry sump, whether or not you get the whole controller, you get the whole system. What they did is they bought the engine from GM Performance. This engine is roughly like $18,000, plus you have to add accessories and stuff like that. So let's just call it 20 grand. And they fit it, they mocked it up, and then what they did is they sent it to Lingenfelter. For anybody who does not know who Lingenfelter is, they've been in the high-performance engine world for many, many, many years. They do a lot with cars in general and racing and so forth. We were actually very proud that we had a vehicle a couple of years ago featured in the booth at SEMA. It was the Lingenfelter booth, and it was Tri-Tip, which was our Pro Touring Camaro that we had that was built by Mark Stilo. So we became friendly with Lingenfelter, so we're very familiar with who they are, and we've built a relationship over the years. So they took the factory 650 horsepower engine, and they took it to 750 horsepower. Again, 750 horsepower. The invoice indicates that it was roughly around $7,000 to do that. So by the time the engine came back and the engine was put in the vehicle, it's safe to say with some of the accessories and everything that there's probably about $30,000 invested in this motor. This is a turnkey motor. This is get in it and drive it motor. This is new technology. It's out of a Corvette originally, this motor. That's what it came from. Z06, I believe. Just an awesome, awesome transplant. Definitely the heart of this car that I'm super proud of. Now, regarding the rest of the engine compartment, obviously the firewall is white, the inner fenders are black, the radiator support is black. It does have a custom show panel on the radiator support. The engine is cooled by an oversized aluminum radiator that looks awesome. It has electric fans and so forth. It's got billet canisters. You can see all of that within our photo gallery. All of the hoses have billet clamps. There's a lot of stainless and braided stuff going on in there. They did a fabulous job with all of that. The engine breathes out of Ultimate headers. That goes into a mandrel bent 3-inch exhaust system, which has Stainless Works mufflers. When you see the undercarriage photos of this car, I'm going to go on record and say it has to be one of the best designed and best built exhaust systems we've ever had at MS Classic Cars. The TIG welding and the craftsmanship that went into this exhaust system was unbelievable. And let me tell you something, it is not cheap to do work like that. No expense was spared on this restoration. When you get in here and you start to feel this great clutch and transmission, you will feel your hand shifting through the gears on this awesome Tremec TKO 600 5-speed, which is an awesome transmission built to handle all the power that that motor can push. And all of that exits to a Ford 9-inch posi rear end that was built very, very strong, again, to handle the horsepower of the motor. So when you talk about the driveline in this car, it is absolutely exceptional. Now, getting into the undercarriage of the car. The bottom side of the car was painted body color. but it was a different type of material paint, more of like a rhino liner, if you will. They did that for durability, sound deadening, and things like this. So it doesn't have the exact finish as the top side. It's more of a crinkled finish on the bottom side, but they thought even a step further. They painted the inner fenders on all four corners black, so that way it wouldn't show, dirt, dust, chips, etc. They just did a really good job thinking all that out. The body of this vehicle was put on a very, very well-known, very expensive Art Morrison AME GT chassis. You have to Google what that is if you don't know what it is. This is only a handful of cars that we've ever owned at MS Classic Cars have Art Morrison chassis. They are like superior brand in the name of custom chassis. This car sits on that. So again, not only do you get the great look, the great interior, the great drivetrain, but now you're getting into hardcore chassis, suspension, brakes, steering, and things like this. So let's touch base on a few things, and I'm going to read this here just because I don't want to mess up regarding what some of that stuff has. So up front, you will find AME's highly acclaimed Sport IFS suspension with its beefy chrome tubular control arms, gold strange coil over shocks with packed springs, adjustable anti-sway bar, and power rack and pinion steering. Superior handling and the ability to handle an abundance of power is assured through the triangulated four-bar rear suspension, and again, the beefy curry is what they refer to it as, 9-inch rear end. Can't say enough about the suspension on this car. This is a true pro touring car. If you want to take this car on a racetrack and have fun with it, it's ready to rock and roll. If you just want to drive it in your local town, cruise the highways, it's great for that. It's also a great show car. You can do whatever you want with it. Now, part of that Art Morrison deal, they used a Wilwood 14-inch drilled and slotted rotors, Wilwood red calipers. There's 6 piston in the front, 4 piston in the rear. Again, it's got an unbelievable braking system, and of course, it's got a Wilwood master cylinder up front as well. So again, these are all huge selling points with this car. There's a lot of little details that I did not want to go over in this video here. Again, you got to visit MS Classic Cars to read the whole description, check out all the photos. Whether you're an enthusiast, whether you're a collector, whatever it is, you will greatly appreciate this car. It is hands down one of the best cars we've ever had at MS Classic Cars. So if you have not signed up for our VIP email blast, please do so. We have thousands of people that follow us. It's the best way to stay in contact with MS Classic Cars. We also would ask that you do follow us on social media as well. We would be really, really happy to have you eventually as a customer here. We're not a big dealership by any means. We're relatively small, but we're really doing great things. So we appreciate you watching. I'm gonna go ahead and start this car, let you listen to how beautiful it runs. It's time to rock and roll and turn great white to life. Fires right up, sounds vicious, purrs like a kitten. Thanks again for watching.